Hello good people, in this tutorial I will show you how to create some modern geometric background effect called Memphis style. There's so many modern design using this style. Okay, let's get started.
Okay, the first thing you do is go to this rectangle and make sure you active this map texture border to make the rectangle fit entirely with this canvas. Okay, change it into white and let's duplicate one more for the shadows and change it into black and send it into back. Okay, now go to this fill and stroke, increase the blur and reduce the opacity, make some shadow look like. Next, let's draw some rectangle in this shape. Go to this rectangle and draw some rectangles again. Now let's change this black color into this blue. You can see this color card and you can input in this box. So I'm going to use the dropper tools. Press D on your keyboard. Click this. Okay, it's turned blue. Let's make some little gradient in here. Make sure you've clicked this blue rectangle and go to this gradient tool and drag it down, change it into this radial in this fill stroke tab. Let's make it out. Press Ctrl Shift on your keyboard so it's proportional and press D. We want to make the light in the center and the outer with this color, so double click the circle. Press D on your keyboard to active this dropper tool and click this. Alright, go to this center again, increase the likeness just a little bit. Okay, now let's make some fluid style to this corner and this. Go to this bezier tool or press B on your keyboard. Let's draw some fluid style. Let's press D on your keyboard for active this dropper tool and click this yellow and remove the strokes. Right click, remove stroke. Okay, and choose this white rectangle. Press Ctrl D to duplicate. We want to make some clipping mesh so it will cut this yellow outer line. Press Shift on this shape and right click, choose this set clip. So it will clip with this white rectangle. Let's make some gradient in here. Make sure you've clicked this shape. Choose this gradient tool. Let's drag it. Make sure some transparency in here. Okay, I think it's nice. Let's make some fluid tool in here. Press B on your keyboard to active this bezier tool. Click to draw. Let's click this and press D on your keyboard to active this dropper tool and click this yellow. Let's remove the stroke. Right click and just remove stroke. Okay, and make some clip. Press Ctrl D. Select these two. Right click, just set clip. And let's set some gradient. Click the shape and just the gradient. Okay, this gradient history that you made before. Change the direction. Click this gradient tool and drag it. Let's add some text in the center. Go to your text tool and make some text. Right, scale it up and change the font into. This Google font is free for personal use and commercial use. You can download in the link description below. Thanks to the creator. Let's add some letter space. Make it 10. Change the text into white. And let's duplicate. Press Ctrl D. Change it into. Scale it down. Okay, now in this Memphis style, we're gonna add some geometrical shape like circle, triangle, the zigzag, and many more. Let's begin with the circle first. Go to the circle and make some circle. Go to this fill and stroke tab. Choose this pattern. And choose this stripe 1-1 white. Now it's like the striped line. Let's rotate it and scale it down. Okay, nice. Let's duplicate, press Ctrl D and place it on here. Okay, pretty nice. Let's add some more. Let's add some more. Go to this star tool. Choose this star shape and make sure the corner is 3 when to make the triangle. Alright. Go to this pattern. Make sure you choose this 1-1 white. Okay, let's scale it down and rotate it a little. Let's add some zigzag shape. Go to this extension. Choose render and gear, right gear. Alright, make sure you active this light preview with contact angle 45 to this maximum. Apply. Scale it up. Make it a stroke. Just right click on stroke, choose white, and increase the stroke width. Make it by 20 pixels and place it on here. Let's duplicate, press Ctrl D. Okay, let's cut a little. Click this line and press delete. Click this line and press delete. Okay, let's duplicate these two. Hold on shift and press Ctrl D. I'm gonna place it here. Make it group. Press Ctrl G and scale it down. Place it on here. Let's add some dotted particles in here. You can see this tutorial in my previous videos about abstract frame. Alright, just click this circle and draw some tiny circle. Remove the stroke. And let's convert it to the object. Let's duplicate, press Ctrl D. Go to extension, generate from path, just interpolate. Make sure you active this live preview. Okay, click apply. Change the color into white. Let's go to the object, transform. Okay, press Ctrl D, then apply. Press Ctrl D, then apply. Okay, repeat the steps. And let's group this. Let's change the opacity to 30. Pretty nice. Let's duplicate, press Ctrl D to here. Scale it down. Send it into back. Let's duplicate one more. Press Ctrl D and place it on here. Make sure you send to the back. Okay, now let's add some line particle. Press B on your keyboard to activate the Bezier tool and draw some lines. Press Ctrl Shift to make the 45 angle. Stroke width to something. Make it rounded, just this round cap. Okay, change the color into white. Right click, just white. And duplicate, press Ctrl D. Let's make it below the shape. Change the color into
Okay, now let's add some basic shape to this canvas like circle, triangle, and other shape. So I'm just gonna speed it. This is it. I hope you enjoy this tutorial and can improve your design with Inkscape. This is one of Memphis style. You can find many different Memphis style in any graphic design store. Okay, Zaki Design. Thanks for watching. Create something good today.